Hi, I'm Martin Tyler. Alan Smith is with me, and we're at the Stadium of Light, the home of Sunderland.
The game today features Sunderland against Tottenham.
An important position in the modern game at fullback, and they've strengthened, haven't they, with this signing?
Yeah, I think you're always looking for athleticism when you're looking at your fullbacks. This is a player that can get up and down all day.
We have three changes for Sunderland today. Ankiyo starts, despite looking shaky in recent games. Jan Kirchhoff plays alongside Lee Catamol in the middle of the park. Jermaine Defoe is the sole striker today. Quite a lot of changes in this Spurs lineup. Hugo Lloris starts in goal. Moussa Dembélé starts with Dele Alli in the centre of the park. And just one out-and-out attacker in the lineup. When they fill it, and the Sunderland fans can do that, the Stadium of Light is as good as anywhere in the Premier League to watch football. They can really bounce around with the noise here.
Yeah, they do love the football up here. They've had to suffer at times as their team have struggled, but it's a wonderful stadium.
It's Graham Scott who is the referee. Spurs have started the first half. Victor Wanyama. Davis. There's the interception. Keeping the move going. He can put them in front.
Gone for goal in spectacular style. Oh. He's expecting him to be wheeling away in celebration there.
Through ball.
Cut up! Oh, saved by the goalkeeper at full strength.
Here's Gilly Bodgy. Well, it will be a throw. It's gone out off that player there.
Good pass. Getting it forward. They cope with it well defensively.
Well defended, not just getting across, he thought quickly as well. Goal news from Bournemouth.
It's a goal for Crystal Palace. It's been scored by Lee Chung-Yong. There were a few questions as to whether it went in as the ball came off the crossbar and down. Lee plays show, it was clearly over the line. 15 minutes played, 1-0.
But many thanks, Alan Mack.
He's got his shot off now.
Tried to keep it down, but it was just too high, only just. Moussa Sissoko. And that news from Alan McAnally that we had to interrupt. A goal for Crystal Palace. And that's the first goal of the game. It's 1-0. Into the attacking third. I don't want to clear his lines here, but make sure it's a bit more than just hooting it upfield. Great interception. Janssen. Tackle goes in. Darren Gibson. Jan Kirchhoff. They spread it out wide here. Chance to get some width into this attack.
The crosses need to be better.
Janssen. Attacking well here. Lee Catamar. Oviedo. And it takes a nick off the player, out for a throw. Interesting to see what footwear the teams are going to actually use today, now that this rain is coming down. Might have to change what they originally started with.
Yeah, and I think sometimes with the lads wearing blades these days, you do see them slipping a bit.
This with a chance to go, Dele Alli scores here. And like most does, it's got an air of grace about it.
And the way he's guided that into the left-hand side of the goal, well, it's wonderful technique.
You can see a slightly different viewpoint on it. And that has opened the scoring. 1-0 here. Catamol. It's good work between these two. Lee Catamol. So Spurs have got this lead. The clock was time on the horizon, of course. It'd be quite a difficult second half for them. They'd like another goal, that's for sure. This could be a very good contest, Alan, because obviously the team that are visiting... He's had a go here! Corner kick, Tottenham Hotspur. To be added on. Catamol tried to tackle here and he's done that. Well, he's thrown possession away. Well, the referee has signaled for half time and it's 1-0 here. Well, I wonder whether the second half is going to find a difference between the two of them, Alan, but at the moment it's really hard to split the two teams.
Yeah, it might be a little tactical switch from a manager that changes the course of this match.
Here we go with the start of the second half. Catamol. On the attack here, just working away to try and find an opening. Now we have a corner to come via that deflection. Place to win the ball back there, because the pressure was starting to mount and the interception was timely, to say the least. Well, this attack got a bit of menace to it. Well, there is a time here when gossip becomes reality, and it is a proper confirmed transfer, we understand. Thibaut Courtois has signed for Juventus.
Well, there were a few in for this boy and this team. In paying around £55 million, made sure they got their man.
There's some potential in this move.
Played into the middle. Goes for it with a fist. Shots on here.
And he's hung on to the ball too. Brilliant goalkeeping.
Make sure the ball is stuck at his foot. Here's Ali. On to the attack now. Quick note for your diary. Make a note of this particular date. EA Sports, we've got the presentation of the Premier League fixture.
Sunderland, they'll be facing Crystal Palace away from home.
Yeah, it's got a good feel about it, that one. Look forward to joining you in the gantry for it.
Well, that's proper defending. They can't score from there, it's out of play.
As for Tottenham, their next game, Alan.
They're playing Middlesbrough in their next match. I can see only one winner. I think they'll find it pretty easy.
Well, time is ticking away. It's time for a change, and here it comes. Here's Ali, and here's the header,
and they have scored, and they do lead now by two, and they've worked very hard for this. It should get them across the line at the end of the match, we'll see.
And the goal looks spectacular and is very important.
Yeah, there was some power behind that effort. I think the crossbar's still shaking.
Starting at 2-0. Just a quick check on the clock, and there are 20 minutes to go. Well, activity on the Sunderland bench. The player's done well here until it was the direction of the pass, really. Right idea, but couldn't find his man. It's out over the touchline. Activity on the bench for the losing team. A substitute getting ready to come on. Moussa Sissoko. I think there's a goal to tell you about from Alan McAnally at the Emirates.
It's a second goal for Arsenal. It's been scored by Alexis Sanchez. A great bit of close control to take the pass on the edge of the area, beat the covering defender and slot the ball home. 74 minutes played, 2-0.
Thank you very much, Alan. Just over a quarter of an hour left on my watch. And he could get away here. Penalty! Wow. Did you see anything cynical in that, Alan?
Well, it is a foul, Martin. He didn't really seem to get his balance right there before making the challenge.
Well, they've got to go for it in these circumstances, haven't they? They're trailing, so an extra potential goal scorer brought on.
But I think he had to do it, didn't he? He's not going to go down with a whimper. This manager wants to go down with a fight, and this is the right way to go about it.
Nothing about these matches, you know that there's always the capacity for a sting in the tail, but Tottenham will be doing everything to avoid being stung now. Tackle here. Attacking well here. Tottenham, chance for them. What we get to see, of course, the assistants don't. Whether that'll change down the years, I'm not sure, but anyway, the replay here shows he's got it right.
He has. I mean, there was no real goal-scoring chance, but the defence would be pleased that their organisation caught him off.
And that'll be a throw. That's a wasted throw. He's given it straight to the opposition. Typified the competitive nature of this game, that tackle. It's only a throw-in. Sunderland wondering whether they can go on and score from here. Here's Ali. Wahbi Khazri. Julian Lescott. Looking to play his teammate through. Dembele. The referee has chosen to add on 4 minutes.
4 minutes.
Moving forward with some danger to the opposition. Now they're here. Was good progress with this attack. And it's a header. That is his final whistle goes. Victory for Tottenham Hotspur. It's a routine time of the season, it always seems, from the outside, maybe for the players themselves, but the job is just the same week in, week out. They've gone about the job here very professionally.
And as long as they can keep things together in this manner and keep on grinding out results, you know what? They're going to be in the shake-up here.